A raucous Raider Nation is most certainly revved up here in Oakland for this interconference matchup between the New Orleans Saints and the Oakland Raiders.
Back in your days when you had to take on a team from the AFC, didn't know them all that well. What was it like as we have this little interconference matchup today?
Well, I thought back in those days, Jim, we were about ready to show them what toughness and hard hitting was. Today it's a little different, but I'll tell you this, this NFC team, they are a hard-hitting bunch.
The Raiders ready to return the kickoff. For a touchback. They face first down. Handoff to the back.
And they're going to run it right.
Nice chunk of yardage picked up by Darren McFadden.
Bill, you always talk about establishing the run early, and they do it with that one big play.
Well, they sure did. This offensive line and that play, they put a whipping on the defensive linemen and linebackers that time, and a good job by the running back taking advantage of it.
Darren McFadden lined up in the backfield. The running back goes in motion. They better hurry to get the snap. Going across the middle, challenges the coverage and has the completion.
Well, it was a nice throw by the quarterback that time to get just enough yards to pick up the first down.
They've got a first down now after that catch. They'll go draw in on the stop.
You cannot let offensive players get up the sideline in the NFL. That's where a lot of big plays are made. The defensive end that time, well, he was on the end, and he stopped that run for very little gain.
Darren McFadden lined up in the backfield. Back to the running back. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
Third and eight.
And the quarterback is taken down.
This defense you're playing against, they're pretty good. So it's fourth down near midfield, punt the football.
He's looking to the right here on this throw. They'll turn it over on downs.
Man, you got to be smarter than that. You can't go for it every single time on fourth and long. There is a thing they have in the NFL. It's called a punt. Do it more often.
On first down. He had no time to get set. Drew Brees has it under center. Second down and 10. Thomas is going to get it out of the eye. They've got him behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, Jim, they didn't pull the defense at all. Second down, you run the football, hoping to make it third and short. Then you lose yards, third and longs. They're hard to get in the NFL.
It'll be third down. And he's is able to get out to the 34-yard line.
That time, the pass is completed into double coverage, Jim, but the quarterback made a bad read. But these receivers, they are so good nowadays. That time, in double coverage, he went up and made the catch. It's like Bill Parcells said to me once about Mark Bavaro, a very talented receiver. He goes, remember, Sims, when he's covered, he's open.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. Wasting no time. Here's the toss to the outside. What a run by Thomas.
Nice run that time by the running back. And if they keep running the football like this, it's just a matter of time before they fake it and throw that football over the top of the defense. They are being physical. The running back doing a good job, and they are making it.
Touchdown, New Orleans.
If you go to an NFL practice, they spend about 40% of their time practicing plays going in to score. And that's why they made it look so easy here. Nice throw by the quarterback on first and goal.
There is a flag. Man, the extra point is good.
Running into the kicker. Defense.
They won't get away with that as he knocks the kicker down. Saints ready here for the kickoff. And a touchback. Defense comes out of the nickel. McFadden's going to take the handoff now.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
The defense comes out in the nickel. Fryer's going to take it from the gun. Looking across the middle. The ball's out. Recovery by the offense. Got a big lane. He's in the clear. The 10. No stopping him. Taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
One thing a defense doesn't want to see, yards after the catch. Yak. And that's what we saw here. The quarterback put it right on target. The receiver is running full speed, catches it, and takes it all the way for a touchdown.
Sebastian Janikowski lining up for the kickoff. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. They come to the line, and it's first down. Play action. Escaping the pressure, challenging the defenders to the right side. Almost intercepted. Drew Brees has it under center. Sproles is going to secure the football on the toss. He's got some daylight.
That time, I got to blame the running back. He made a bad read. His vision was terrible. He makes the wrong decision, and it cost his team yards lost.
Nickel formation here for the defense. Third and 10. He'll fire it out to the left. Woodson with the interception. He's got a wide open alley.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, They read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
Terrell Pryor backs off the line. Shotgun formation.
First and goal.
Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Second down and a long way to go. The pass fails to find the mark.
This is frustrating for a coach. You call a play, you get the receiver down the field on a corner route, and your quarterback cannot put it on the target.
Split backfield here. Third and a long way to go. Going to take off with it. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
By the looks of that, you can tell it looks like a major injury. And it's a tough sport, a lot of big hits, and I hope he's going to be okay.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Fourth and goal to go. That's a missed opportunity, and now they'll have to bring out the defense.
Well, that's four plays and out for the offense, and that was bad. Bad play calling, bad play, bad execution. Go to the bench and try to rethink what you're doing.
Drew Brees has it under center. First and 10. The quarterback will hand it off.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The Saints offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway. Coming up, second down. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Rocks him with that hit, and the ball's going to fall incomplete.
Let's just tell it like it is, Jim Nance. His receiver's not a very tough guy because he gets hit. It should have been a complete pass, but he gets hit. He just throws that football on the ground, and the pass is incomplete.
Thomas lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Third and 6. They go draw. Looking for some daylight up the middle. The call is for encroachment. That's 5.
Yeah, they too impatient on the defense's part there. They're too anxious to get to the quarterback. And Jim, that's just a good break for the offense right there.
That flag gives them a new set of downs. Working that left side. And it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit.
Good anticipation that time by the defender. He gets to the receiver just as the football is arriving. And he makes a beautiful hit to knock the football loose.
Nickel formation for the defense here. Play action fake. Looking for an open receiver on the right. And Tyvon Branch has the tackle.
It's always good when your quarterback is able to deceive the defense with good play action fakes. That's what did it that time. Look at the quarterback. Nice fake. Defense reacts to the run, and now you throw it over the top for the easy completion.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. Takes it from the eye. They bring him to the turf.
Number 23, the ball carrier. Gain of 6 on the play. Drew Brees has it under center.
A second and three. Out of the eye, they give it to the tailback.
Pierre Thomas with a nice piece of running.
Good job by the running back that time, finding the open hole and picking up those extra yards.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. He leaps up to grab it.
Well, there's nothing the defense can do. When you talk about a receiver like these guys out there now, and this one in particular, the double coverage, they're still able to go in between the defenders, rise up, and make the catch.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Darren Sproles takes the football.
The offense is so close right here. They just need to show a little power and punch this in the end zone and get that touchdown.
Second down now. Ball is snapped and the quarterback tosses it to the outside.
How about the defensive line? Getting that penetration, getting off the football at the snap, and getting it done, getting in the backfield and making that tackle.
Marching down the field and taking their time.
Third and goal at the six. He's in for the score.
Anytime, Jim, it's third and goal, you've got to decide, what are we going to do? Well, this time the offense, nice design. They throw the football, and the quarterback puts it right on the money for the touchdown pass.
The Raiders ready to return the kickoff.
No return. The ball's coming out to the 20.
First down, offense readying for the snap.
He'll throw it over the middle. Oh, almost caught.
Play doesn't even have time to develop. The quarterback is under so much pressure, he's throwing it before these receivers are even ready.
The Saints set at the line. Dime package. Friars got it in the gun. Reaches out and grabs it.
Nice job by the quarterback finding the open guy short. They get the completion. They still do not get the first down, though.
Third down here. Offense trying to pick up the first. He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
The NFL is about situations. A good job by the runner knowing where the first down was, gets it there, and he moves those chains.
They run right.
And he is tackled at the 44.
Good job that time by the running back getting down the field and picking up big yards.
We've hit the two-minute warning here in the first half. New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground.
Makes the reception. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Running back in motion here. Pryor's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Throws the pass. And incomplete.
The defense has really done a good job here in this drive. They got this offense in a third and long situation. Let's see if they can convert it.
Ohio! Ohio!
plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
In trouble now. Throwing now to his left. And the throw is incomplete.
You cannot play quarterback in the NFL anymore if you don't have good footwork. And that means inside the pocket or outside the pocket. Avoid those sacks.
Formation here for the defense. The quarterback unable to get the playoff in time, and that'll be a 5-yard penalty for delay of gain. Tight ends. Looking to the right side and throwing. Makes the catch in the open field. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Well, you get a couple first downs on a drive. It just, of course, it makes you feel good about what you're doing. It loosens up the offensive play caller, and there's nothing like dictating to the defense. I love it.
Darren McFadden lined up in the backfield.
Second and 5.
The tackle was going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
Nothing like seeing a complete offense. That's what we're watching here today. Yes, we know they can throw it, but what they're showing us here, they can grind out some first downs running the football, too.
Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Hard to tell exactly what the injury is, Jim, but I can just tell it's the lower part of the body. And, you know, that was a tough hit. And I hope he's able to come back in the game later today.
First down, throwing again. Looks to his left. Makes the grab. Breaks the plane. And he's got the touchdown.
Well, here we are. It's a tie game now. We'll see how the teams react to it. Will it be positive or negative?
They're going to bypass the point after and try to pick up the two-point conversion. Trying to make something happen. You talk about momentum. That turns into an 8-point trip, the touchdown and the two.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So, hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point. Or 2 points. Nice job that time.
Tackles made. Offense lines up here. First and 10. Screen pass. Darren Sproles makes the catch. Breaks free. Tyvon Branch in on that last play.
Nice play call that time by the offensive coordinator. A little screen pass to the halfback. He knew the defensive line was going to be charging hard. They were, and it picked up some nice yards.
First and 10. The pass down the field by Drew Brees. And it's incomplete.
Well, for some reason, this quarterback likes to keep trying to go deep down the field against this cover, too. That's not the spot you want to go. You want to look underneath or right down the middle.
That leads us to second down. Throws to the right.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football. The results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. First and 10. Going across the middle.
Interception. Makes a move, and he's free.
What a terrible job by the quarterback. But nobody's open. Tries to force the pass, and look, what's it turn into? An interception.
Ready for intermission. First, one more play. Jimmy Graham with the grab. And that's going to do it for the first half, folks. We'll be back to Raiderland for the start of the second half after this. We're back here now in this one where the Raiders lead by one. Going to be a penalty here. I saw the coach down on the sideline, and he is furious about that ball being kicked out of bounds.
Shoot, I have no stake in this game. I'm mad, too. You got to kick it off. The field is 53 yards wide, and we couldn't kick it in between those 53 yards. It's like you hitting the driver. You can't keep it on the fairway.
Here's the quick toss to the running back. Breaks away. They've got him down there. Quarters formation here for the defense. And Sproles gets the football. He's got some daylight. Gonna take it home for the touchdown.
Now you know why running backs get drafted high. Because these long running plays for touchdowns, that's what you want. That's what the NFL is about. Making big plays, and when you get them in the running game, that's like double good.
Add the extra point. The kick is good. Saints ready here for the kickoff. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The defense comes out of the dime. First and 10. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Vaccaro on the tackle.
Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws, sooner or later that defense is going to come up. And when they come up, that's when you throw it over the top.
Second down coming up. Here's the handoff to Darren McFadden. They deck him in the backfield.
By that time, the defense gets the tackle behind the line of scrimmage. And listen, I blame this one on the quarterback. When you see the defense in a situation like that, you must change the play. Don't waste one in the NFL. You don't get enough chances as it is, and that one lost yards.
There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
When you're behind in a football game, all you can do on the offensive side is just go out there and thinking about making plays and picking up first downs. Good job by the offense.
First and 10, they'll run it off the toss. Gets away from the pressure, and it's Curtis Lofton who makes the play. Terrell Pryor will be under center. On second and 3, challenging the defenders to the right side.
As much as these guys practice during the offseason, training camp, during the week, you think receivers and quarterbacks would always be on the same page. That time they were not, and it's another incomplete pass.
So after that last incompletion, it is 3rd and 3. Scrambling out of the pocket. Has some space to work with.
Jim, when you get inside the other team's red zone, inside the 20-yard line, and you're down some points, you're thinking touchdown in these situations.
This play set up by the long gainer. It's intercepted! He's brought to a halt. offense lines up here.
First and 10. Pierre Thomas takes the handoff, and he's brought to the ground.
This will be second down.
Halfway through the third quarter. Quarterback, quick toss to the outside. Shakes off the tackle. Gains maybe five.
This is third down. They'll run it with him again. That brings the play to an end.
Offense lines up here.
Staying on the ground, and he'll try it left.
This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
First down here after the run.
Quarterback flips it to the running back.
And that's good for only a yard or two.
Good job by the defensive player squaring up that running back and just putting his big butt right into the ground.
Drew Brees has it under center.
Quarterback drops back, play action. Looking for an open receiver on the right.
And sailing out of bounds.
Morgan's a receiver in the slot.
Looking across the middle, and the pass is picked by Woodson. He's brought down.
Well, I have to say, that's just a terrible decision by the quarterback there. He's got to know when you're in a situation like this, you just cannot make that type of pass.
McFadden's lined up directly behind the quarterback here.
They tackle him for a loss.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Second down following the run.
Right where it had to be.
What a nice catch by the receiver. Getting past the yard markers, makes the catch and gets a first down.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play.
Could have been intercepted. Too much pressure on the quarterback on that play, Phil.
That defense, boy, oh boy, are they aggressive, and they can get after the quarterback. We saw it on that play. This is going to be a tough assignment for this offensive line today.
And here we have second down.
And the give to Darren McFadden. He's tackled at the 28.
You got to keep your offensive linemen aggressive, so you have to run the football every once in a while. That run, even though it was a short game, it served a purpose.
Throws a strike.
When you play zone in the NFL, what you're trying to do is make the quarterback hold the football just for a half a second longer, and you hope the pass rush can get there. They don't that time. That's why he got the completion.
The defense gets a sack.
Well, that's a good job by the defense that time, getting the sack on the blitz. And when you blitz, you're taking a chance. You better get to the quarterback, and that time they did.
McFadden's lined up as the single back. Looking to the right side and throwing. It's incomplete. The defender had it for a moment, but could not pick it off cleanly. Third down.
Moores lined up now as a slot receiver.
Third and 16.
Play action fake. Looking to throw. Almost intercepted that time.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work. And they stop the offense that time.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Scrambling now. The throw to the left. That ball is going the other way.
That was a terrible throw by the quarterback. When you're off target like that, you deserve to throw an interception.
Drew Brees has it under center. Not a wise throw there into double coverage. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here.
Sproles up the middle.
Not many middle linebackers do this anymore in the NFL. They usually are just runners, but not my man here. He can go up inside and stuff runs with the best of them.
The Saints offense tries to continue some momentum, still possessing the football as the final quarter gets underway. Sproles is in the backfield. The final quarter begins with this snap. He has the grab.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
Throws to the right. Makes the catch. And he's got the first down.
That's what you want to do. Get a first down while you're on top and keep that clock moving and just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense managing things so far here today.
Here we go.
First and 10. He's looking to the right here on this throw. No one's going to get him now. The 20, the 10, all the way home and all alone. Touchdown.
What a terrible job by the defense. That time, nobody even covers the receiver. He is wide open down the field, and, hey, nice job by the quarterback going through his progression. He finds the open guy and gets a touchdown pass.
Gets away from the pressure, challenging the defenders to the right side. That hurts. The two-point try is denied. The Raiders ready to return the kickoff. Going to take it the distance. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
I don't even want to speculate what the injury is, but I think it's safe to say by just watching the player, he's in a lot of pain, and I hope it's not serious.
Lined up in the pistol formation. Pryor standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Taking off. Steps out of bounds.
Well, good job that time by the defense, getting pressure on the quarterback, but you can't let him break the pocket. Look at this time. He breaks the pocket. He's looking down the field. Nobody open, so he decides to run and picks up some big yards.
He'll throw it over the middle. Breaks the tackle. They break through. Tackle him behind the line.
Well, the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
Terrell Pryor will be under center. A takeaway. They pounce on him there.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
First down on the way. Sproles is taking the handoff. They knock him down, and he's still 2 yards short of the first.
Good job that time by the offense. Power run gets him a few yards.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Second and two. Darren Sproles takes the football. Takes it the distance for the touchdown.
There is nothing like getting a long running play for a touchdown. When you do, you just feel like you're stealing something. It takes good blocks, but most importantly, it takes a talented running back to get it done, and this team definitely has one.
Get set, looking to convert on this two-point try. So, put down a touchdown and a two-point conversion on that occasion.
Yeah, good job by the offense. They executed the play perfectly, and they got in the end zone, like you said, and got that 2 points.
Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. McFadden's lined up in a single back formation. First down and 10. Eyeing that left side. Ball is caught.
Well, if you want to be a good play action pass team, it's always nice to have a good running game. Make the defense dig in and try to stop your run. When they do that, you fool them. You fake it, you throw it down the field. That's about as easy as it gets.
Terrell Pryor will be under center. Halfback sent in motion. First and 10. Looking for a receiver on the left side here. Thrown incomplete.
Ohio! Ohio!
Watch the blitz. Darren McFadden lined up in the backfield. Ball's going to be incomplete, and a hit knocked the ball out.
You might as well catch it because you're going to take the big hit no matter what. That time, the receiver lets the ball go because he was worried about the defender making
Ohio,
the hit.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. Running a little college-like option.
Good job that time by the running back. I'm sure he's a little winded after that play. He showed that speed getting out there and picking up those extra yards.
Ohio! Ohio!
Terrell Pryor will be under center. First and 10. A pass complete. He's tackled at the 30.
Perfect defense call that time. They allowed the catch. The coach on the sidelines going, well, what else do you want me to do? We had the guy double covered, and you still couldn't make the play.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Looking to go up top again on first down. Bringing the play to an end.
Well, even though they're down more than seven here, the offense down the red zone, it'll be good for them for the rest of this game. Their confidence for the offensive coach if they can punch this in for the touchdown.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. Wide to the left. That'll stop the play right there.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let them. If they do, of course it'll be a touchdown.
I think you got to be a little more creative in the red zone than this. When you just line up and run the football like that, you're not going to.
And he's in for the touchdown. There's the signal from the far side. It is a touchdown. He broke the plane. He broke the plane from just a yard away. Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history. And they'll go. So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure 2 extra points. Raiders ready for action. They're not going to risk the big return, so here's the squib kick. Batten's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than 7, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
Now first and 10. Mick Batten, good piece of tackling.
Well, if you're a good running back, when there's not a lot there, you find a way to make some extra yards. Here in the red zone, it's even more important.
The Raiders come to the line with 5 wideouts and no one in the backfield. Brings it in. And it's Roman Harper who makes the tackle.
You need a lot of variety when you get down here in the game. You're losing. You're close to the goal line. You've got to catch the defense by surprise. Can't wait to see this play call.
A tackle behind the line.
So many things you could do on first down. And what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
It's now second down. Touchdown. That'll close the gap.
Well, it's a nice touchdown that time. You're still down under 2 minutes to play, and there's no doubt we're going to see the onside kick. And these onside kicks, these kickers are great, so we don't know who's going to win this game yet.
Lining up now for the two-point conversion. So they get the touchdown, but they go for two and fail to convert.
I'll be the first to say it. That was a terrible decision to go for the 2 points. I'll give the defense some credit, but mainly the blame goes to the offensive play call.
The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. The Raiders defense lined up going with the 46 defense. And Ingram's going to take the handoff from the eye.
What that run does, it just puts the offense in a good situation. So a good, positive run.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. Three-step drop. And they sack the quarterback. The Raiders are going to burn the first of their 3 timeouts right here. The offensive line gets in position. Can they protect their quarterback? Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
Bad job that time by the quarterback. He misses the receiver on the slant route. When you're throwing the slant route, you got to throw it right into the stomach of the receiver so it's easy for him to make the catch and he can protect himself also.
Drew Brees has it under center. Looking for an open receiver on the right. And they'll turn it over on downs. The defense does a fantastic job holding strong. Mick Badden's in the backfield. Single back set. He'll fire it out to the left. And almost picked off.
That's a nice route that time by the wide receiver. Running the corner route, and the quarterback just throws it too far and misses it.
The Raiders come to the line of scrimmage with two timeouts to play with. And the tackle is made at the 48-yard line. The quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time.
I think this is one of the easier throws in the NFL. Don't make the mistake throwing it up the field. Throw it across the field so the receiver can run to it. That time, the quarterback leads the receiver way too far on the post route.
Butler's lined up in the slot. Pryor's back in shotgun formation. Intercepted. Breaks free. Has some space to work with. Touchdown in the late stages. That touchdown might just wrap it up.
Yeah, it sure will, Jim. It's been an exciting game all day. And it to score late in the game like this, to put it away, it's time to celebrate a little on the sideline.
Lining up now for the two. Looking to the right side and throwing. Got touchdowns, got 2-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do. And you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
The receiving team has the recovery. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. He sends the halfback in motion. From the gun. Waits for an opening to unfold. Incomplete. Well, they go for the bomb, but the defensive backfield was not fooled.
Yeah, they were all over it that time, and they just, that was like shadow defense. Wherever the receiver was going, the defense was right next to him. Great job.
Second and 10. Shakes off the hit. Oh, that could have been intercepted, but he couldn't hold on.
This drives coaches crazy. They get a wide receiver open down the field on a post route, and what happens? The quarterback just overthrows him.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. Darren McFadden will run with it. The tackle is made, but the first down is picked up.
That's one of those plays. If it doesn't work, everybody's going to get on the offensive coordinator for running the football there late in the game when they're behind. But he caught the defense off guard. It was a good risk by them and a good game.
And this will probably wrap up the game. There's some shifting around in the backfield. First and 10. Throws to the right. And the pass is intercepted. It's going the other way, and this game is all but over. That's going to do it. The clock hits zero, and this game has come to an end.